So now we're going to help you with packaging and deploying the new remote help app that allows you some remote support and remote assistance within Windows 365 leveraging Intune. So I've got an elevated command prompt open. I'm going to paste in this command, Intune WinApp util, telling it this is the location, this is the executable, and this is where we want to drop that Intune WinApp deployment. So I'm going to hit enter. We let it overwrite, no big deal. Just that simple. Let's check it out and see if we did it right. You can see here we have the .intune win file. So now we're ready to start doing the deployment. So let's move over to that. Now we're back inside of Intune. We're ready to deploy out that application. So we're going to go apps, Windows. We're going to hit add. From here, we select Windows app, select. We're going to select our package file that we just built. So here we go. We select that app. So I'm going to rename it just because I like to make it a little bit nicer. I mean, you can get crazy with it, but I don't really need to. I'm going to put Microsoft as the publisher. Hit next. Now we're going to add a few things here. So for the install command, so now you can see here we added the install command with the name that the exe had before we built the package. The uninstall. Leave everything else off as default. Hit next. Now here we're just going to select whatever meets your environment. So we'll go like 64-bit for operating system. We'll say, 20H2. This just kind of depends on what your requirements are, but it doesn't really a big deal. Now we go to detection rules. From here, we're going to collect manually configure rules. We hit add, select file, and then for path, we're going to put C program files, remote help. It helps when you can type. Remotehelp.exe is the file. Detection method, we're going to go string version greater than or equal to. That's your value. We're going to leave that set to no. We're going to hit OK. Go next. Don't need to leave any dependencies in there or that. Scope tags. We're going to add a group here. Add our Windows 365 group. Next. Create. And with that, it's just that simple. And you have that app deployed out so you can do all your great remote assistance.